Last month, the Boring Company's Las Vegas tunnel opened to the public, and boy was it underwhelming. The finished product is closer to the experience of driving under your local highway than it is to the high-speed futuristic mode of transportation that was proposed. There's no super cool elevators that take you into the tunnel. The cars aren't running on sleds, they're actually manually driven. And the top speed is a whopping 40 miles per hour. I don't think you'd be surprised to hear that neither fans nor critics were impressed by the tunnel. I don't think Elon Musk is that proud of the loop either, as he didn't even attend the opening. The president of the Boring Company, Steve Davis, was also not present at the opening. In the meantime, the Boring Company quietly removed the DC Baltimore Tunnel and the LA Dugout Loop from its list of future projects, which has not gone unnoticed by the media. So, given the underwhelming nature of the Las Vegas Loop and the probable cancellation of these upcoming tunnels, is the Boring Company dead? Well, in order to answer this question, we're gonna take a look at the top promises made by the Boring Company and analyze its viability based on the finished loop. To start it off, we have transportation volume. One of the biggest promises Elon Musk made when it came to the Boring Company was its ability to move massive amounts of people. According to Elon, the final goal is to move 50,000 passengers per hour. A quick look at the speed of the cars entering the Las Vegas loop would draw heavy skepticism to this goal. The Boring Company has likewise advertised a much lower transportation volume of 4,400 passengers per hour with the Las Vegas loop, but many think that even this is pushing it. Taking a look at the clips of cars entering the tunnel, we can see that if anything, there's a car entering the tunnel once every 5 seconds. I highly doubt that this is the average rate throughout the entire day, but we'll say it is to give them the benefit of the doubt. This means that 720 cars pass through the tunnel every hour. Even if every single one of them was a Model X and carried a full 6 passengers excluding the driver, we only get a total of 4,320 passengers per hour. That is close to the advertised volume of 4,400 passengers per hour, but let's be real, we had to really stretch it to get to that number. In reality, it's going to take more than 5 seconds for 6 passengers to just get into the car itself. So even if there was enough demand, it would basically be impossible to get a car into the tunnel every 5 seconds. A more reasonable estimate would be 15 seconds per car, but that alone would reduce the passengers per hour to a little less than 1,500. And let's not forget, that's assuming that every single car is filled with 6 people. So, unfortunately, the Boring Company is nowhere close to 50,000 passengers per hour, and it doesn't seem like they'll be reaching such numbers anytime soon. Moving on, another major promise made by the Boring Company was high speeds of transportation. The visualization released in 2017 showcases the Model S traveling at speeds up to 200 kilometers per hour, or about 124 miles per hour. As we mentioned at the beginning though, the newly opened tunnel only supports speeds up to 40 miles per hour. It should be noted that the Las Vegas loop is only 1.7 miles though, so the tunnel would probably be able to handle higher speeds if it was longer. Length isn't the only bottleneck with the current Boring Tunnel though. Another major factor holding back the tunnel is the fact that the cars are manually driven. A person can only drive so fast through those cramped tunnels, and expecting drivers to constantly drive at even 80 miles per hour doesn't seem like the smartest of ideas. This is why autonomous driving was basically a necessity with the Boring Company. I'm pretty sure the Tesla Autopilot is advanced enough to drive through the Boring Tunnel, so I'm not quite sure why they decided to launch with drivers. But whatever their reason, the lack of autonomy is heavily limiting their transportation speeds. Something else that's hindering the Boring Company's top speeds is a lack of tracks and a lack of exit/entrance ramps. Generally, when you don't have to focus on steering the vehicle, you can travel much faster. The only thing holding back your speed when you're using tracks is derailment. As long as you're going slower than the physics allow for, there shouldn't be any problems with the tracks. Also, as for the exit and entrance ramps, these were critical in getting vehicles up to speed before they entered the main tunnel and slowed them down after exiting the main tunnel. With that being said though, it shouldn't be too hard for the Boring Company to make larger tunnels in the future with autonomous driving and entrance/exit ramps. So, the ambition for high speeds isn't lost yet. Aside from promising to quickly transport large amounts of people, the Boring Company promised to drive down construction costs. One of the biggest criticisms of subways is their massive price tags, and Elon assured us that he could do it for cheaper. The Las Vegas tunnel ended up costing $52.5 million. With 1.7 miles of track, this comes out to $30 million per mile. That's not quite the promised $10 million per mile, but that's not bad by any means, especially when you consider the cost of regular subways. San Francisco Central Subway, for instance, is also 1.7 miles, but it comes in at an eye-popping $1.6 billion. And that was just the original estimate. In December of 2020, it was expected that the final cost would be 15% higher. This means that each mile of the subway literally costs $1 billion. Now, you might be thinking that longer subways are more cost-effective, but that's not always the case. Just take a look at the LA Purple Line extension. The length of this project is 9 miles, but the cost per mile doesn't seem to be any better, as the total project is estimated to cost $8.4 billion. That's the same as $930 million per mile. And that's not even as high as it goes. The New York East Side Access Subway is estimated to cost $3.7 billion per mile. As you can see, it's not unusual for subways in the US to cost hundreds of millions of dollars, if not billions per mile. So, the Boring Company's cost of $30 million per mile is still quite favorable. One thing that we should note though is that the diameter of subway tunnels are much larger than that of the Boring Company. The average diameter of subways is 20 feet, while the diameter of the Las Vegas Loop is only 12 feet. This means that for 1 mile of subway tunnel, you have to dig out 1.66 million cubic feet of dirt. For 1 mile of Boring Tunnel, however, you only have to dig out 600,000 cubic feet of dirt. If we scale up the Boring Company's price tag, we'll see that it would cost them about $83 million per mile if their tunnels were as big as subway tunnels. Even if we round it up and call it $100 million per mile, the Boring Company's price is still significantly lower than the average subway in the US. So, the Boring Company may indeed be onto something when it comes to cost efficiency. These low construction costs, however, aren't that useful when you don't have a high number of passengers traveling through your tunnel. If the total number of passengers is low, the cost per passenger will still be super high. Let's say the goal is to make back your investment in 5 years. If we assume that it costs $10 million per year to run the tunnel, we get a total of $50 million worth of operational expenses. Add that to the $52.5 million construction cost, and we get a total of about $100 million. If we spread that over 5 years, the tunnel would have to bring in an average of $2,283 every single hour. At the Boring Company's advertised capacity of 4,400 passengers per hour, we actually get a super cheap price of just about 50 cents per ride. Even at our more reasonable estimate of 1,500 passengers per hour, each seat should only cost $1.50, which is still not bad. Now, the Las Vegas Convention Center is charging $5 to $10 per ride, but I'm pretty sure that's just because they can and not because they need to. So, it's quite possible that the Boring Company will be able to offer ticket prices as low as $1 as promised. But let's be real here, aside from beating out subways in terms of cost efficiency, the Boring Company hasn't really done anything new. The final product is nothing like the animations, and there's really no arguing against that. And I doubt the Boring Company will get there anytime soon, if ever. I've always been skeptical about the underground highway system happening, but I did think that larger loop projects like the Washington to Baltimore loop would come to fruition in the 2030s or 2040s. But now, I'm actually leaning towards the side of these projects never happening, either. And the turning point for me has been Elon's silent concession over the past several months. Elon has worked on extremely ambitious projects throughout his life, and he's still working on things like reaching Mars and developing fully autonomous cars. But the difference between those projects and the Boring Company is that Elon is all in on those visions. Elon didn't actually want to do the Boring Company in the first place. He thought he already had too much on his plate, and so he actually wanted someone else to try it. The only reason he started the Boring Company was because no one else was giving the idea a shot. Moreover, it didn't take him long to admit that the final version wasn't nearly as impressive as the visualization. In October of 2020, he tweeted, "We simplified this a lot. It's basically just Teslas and tunnels at this point." In April, the Boring Company took down two of their main projects from their website, and now he wasn't even there for the opening of their first operational tunnel. So, I don't think Elon is all in on the Boring Company by any means, and I don't think it's unreasonable to think that he might even fully concede the original vision. Does this mean that the Boring Company itself will be shut down? Not necessarily. It does seem like the Boring Company is able to dig these tunnels for significantly cheaper, and this ability is quite valuable. The Boring Company may shift to work on digging tunnels for high-speed rails, bullet trains, and maybe even hyperloops one day. But the idea of building an underground transport system based on cars is basically dead, in my opinion. Do you guys think the Boring Company can make a comeback? Comment that down below. Also, drop a like if you would like to see the Boring Company focus on high-speed rail. And of course, consider joining our Discord community to suggest future video ideas, and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.